Civilian death toll is rising in Gaza. Israeli airstrikes hit a United Nations school, killing at least 40. And this was supposedly a safe place where hundreds of Palestinian refugees were trying to shelter from the violence.
Regarding the conflict in Gaza, a senior United Nations official tells NBC News there have been a total of 4 UN buildings, including schools and health clinics, hit by Israel in the past 24 hours. Hundreds of Palestinians were using at least 2 of those buildings, the schools, as a shelter from the violence. And this as the death toll tops 500 in Gaza, and the Red Cross calls the situation there a full-blown humanitarian crisis. On the phone with us now, Julian Manyan with ITN. He is in Erez Checkpoint, that is the Israeli-Gaza border. Julian, tell us, we know that Israel has said that they would go to great lengths to avoid civilian casualties. Why then hit this building, these shelters, if in fact that's what they were, shelters?
Yes, it's only a short time ago since the Israeli Prime Minister Ehud Olmert remarked that his government would treat the Palestinian civilians with kid gloves. That, of course, has not taken place today. We still don't understand exactly why so many UN buildings were hit in the space of one day. We've only had an Israeli explanation for one of them, that is the school in the Jabalia refugee camp, where about 30 people died. And the Israeli claim there is that they were fired upon from that school by Hamas mortars, and that their mortars returned fire to the point of origin of the Palestinian fire. That at least is what they say. People who were actually there have an account of quite simply Israeli shells landing and horrific civilian casualties taking place. And there are, of course, the attacks on at least 2 other Palestinian schools under the UN flag to be accounted for. We haven't had any explanation for those at all.